Welcome to How Hard Could It Be, where we go through how hard it is to do that whole YouTube thing of making videos, entertaining the masses, and trying to boost that sweet, sweet subscriber count. But first, let's roll that beautiful game footage. Yeah, that's better. So hello everyone, let's talk about Burnout. No, not that. No, get that off the screen. No. I mean video game Burnout. The process by which one plays a certain game in a certain way so much that they don't want to play it anymore. First, I'd like to talk a little about why I think it happens. Then the ways that developers try to prevent us from getting burnt out. Then, why we ignore them. And finally, what we as gamers can do to prevent it from happening to ourselves. So, why do we experience burnout? Burnout happens because we as gamers are incentivized to play games in a certain way. Maybe it's grinding raids, endless mission types, or generally just doing one thing over and over again. Sometimes this is purposeful. One can only get arcanes in Warframe from Eidolon hunts. In Monster Hunter, various armor sets have rare parts that must be attained from certain monsters, and some of the best weapons are only available from Kol'Vatoroth. Borderlands 2 has much the same issue. If you want an Infinity, you better be ready to kill Doc Mercy a few hundred times to get a drop, let alone the one you want. This leads to my first point, random number generation. RNG is probably the most blatant culprit of this problem. We often fall victim to such mechanizations. Whether it's raids, special monsters, or other forms of grinding, one can often find themselves at the mercy of RNG. Sometimes it's tied to low drop chances, or high resource costs, or both. One can easily get stuck in a cycle of doing the task for the reward, not getting what we need, and trying again. That repetition of no progress can easily lead to burnout. Similar to how fear leads to the dark side. The second source of burnout is far off goalposts. A few months ago, the very first Night Wave was released on Warframe and just recently finished. For those of you who may not play Warframe, Night Wave was essentially a free version of the Battle Pass systems that are available in many Battle Royales. It included many unique rewards, both cosmetic and gameplay affecting. It required us
26 million registered losers
to do a variety of tasks, ranging from the simple kill enemies with a certain element combination to more involved mission goals such as hunting a hydrolist or a 60-minute Kuva survival without using an AirPod. I think many of us got caught up in having to do it all, when in reality, that wasn't completely necessary. The end goal to attain level 30 was around 70% of the axe. On top of that, there were boosts from unique enemies, the Saturn VI fugitives. In situations like this, fear of missing out can hit particularly hard, making it a situation where we feel we have to get through it all right now. This raises the stakes, making us play longer, harder, and boom, burnout. One can even find themselves getting burnt out simply from playing a single game for too long, day in and day out. Whether this affects you or not is likely up to your own psyche and how you handle repetition and similar challenges. Maybe you find this to be an issue, maybe you don't. It can be a game-by-game basis. Maybe you get burnt out on the repetition of a game like Destiny, but due to an ever-changing meta, you can play League for months and never hit that limit. Genre burnout is also a big thing to keep yourself aware of. Popular games seem to tend toward trends, and when they do, many games with similar mechanics are released. The looter shooter, the open world sandbox, and the survival game all fit into this problem. If you've played one, you might as well have played them all. And if you've played them all one after another, you might find yourself being burnt out by an entire genre or subgenre of games. Burnout, like many things in life, is subjective. So, how do developers try to stop us from being burnt out? There are many developers that do try to reduce burnout, or at least prolong the process so it doesn't happen as easily. For example, DFO uses a fatigue system, meaning that you can only run a certain amount of mission tiles before you can't play on that character anymore. You can certainly pay your way around that problem by purchasing fatigue potions, but they still have that initial limiter. MapleStory 2 has a similar system where you have around 30 dungeons you can do per day and 6 raids per week, but that's for each character. One is a soft cap that you can pay your way around, the other a hard cap that you can't get around except by playing another character. Warframe, my main center for understanding Burnout, has many systems for this. Most of them are through their syndicate systems, which don't completely prevent you from playing the game, but de-incentivizes you from certain areas, such as the open world segments or fiddling with your passive syndicates. Nightwave itself only has a limited number of acts you can do per week, meaning that you can finish your weeklies, often in as little time as a single day, and then you barely need to do anything for the rest of the week, aside from clearing some simple objectives, such as bullet jump, marking resources, or elemental kills. They even partially nullify FOMO by releasing old event items into other game modes or through special vendors, like Barrowketeer. And then, some don't even bother to try. It's not something that's on their mind. It's so far away from their minds that they can even create their games in such ways that seem to practically punish you for playing. Anthem is widely regarded as unrewarding due to the excessive grind for little payout. The Borderlands series has no limiters and no guarantees that you'll get what you want or need. Many games can even encourage destructive behavior, acting in a way that goads you into doing nothing but dive into this one game. That is likely done to force higher player counts. Keeping you in the game is their only goal, and by keeping you in the game, they keep the game in the internet zeitgeist for just a bit longer. This isn't always a bad thing, so long as the game remains rewarding for your grind or gameplay, but it does mean that you as a player need to take the initiative to prevent yourself from being burnt out. I'll talk about that later, of course. So, developers can try to reduce burnout through soft caps, hard caps, and de-incentivization of play, but does it work? Not always. In fact, it probably never works. Not completely. So how and why do we ignore these limiters? In DFO and MapleStory, just playing a different character allows you to do more dungeons, more missions, and completely relieves you of being inhibited by the burnout prevention methods. And even if you completely use up all of those mission counters on all your characters, you can always just make a new account if you're that dead set on getting around it. De-incentivization of play, such as how DE tries to do things, doesn't work because sometimes you're just fine grinding away, even without extra benefits from play due to other rewards listed in a mission type or area. In essence, it boils down to, we want the stuff! We want the loot! We want to improve our builds! We want to boost that sweet, sweet DPS! We want that new mod, new weapon, new widget that will decorate our perfectly crafted characters. We want it all, even at the detriment to ourselves and the enjoyment of our games, and we'll ignore or find a way around whatever limiters are put on us if we have to. It's important to realize that when it comes to burnout, we are part of the problem. But if we are part of the problem, how can we prevent it from happening to ourselves? If you find yourself playing only one game, be mindful of the grind. It's important to reflect on why you're playing a game. Are you fueled only by the grind, or is it the gameplay that drives you? Is your goal urgent, exclusive, or timed? Maybe it's something that will come back and you can attain it later when you're in a better position to play. Sometimes you can afford to wait, especially if you're already on the Sith path to burnout. Grinding leads to anger. Anger leads to burnout. Burnout leads to suffering. I think that, as much as possible, you should play for the gameplay. Let grinding sit on the sidelines when it can. Grinding shouldn't be the end result. It should be the happy accident alongside the main goal of just having fun. Excluding that mentality, take a break. Take plenty of breaks. Always remember that there are other games out there. New AAA video games come out very often. Maybe take a trip to a new world that you haven't explored yet. Indie games are coming out all the time. Some of them expansive, and some of them bite-sized. Give those struggling artists a try and see if they have something worth enjoying. Remember to reflect back on old favorites and play some of the games you've left behind in the past. You've played them for a reason, so they still have merit, even if they're old, faded, and maybe haven't aged well. Even the realm outside of video games has things to offer. Draw a picture, even if it sucks. Get some watercolors and do something, even if it looks kinda bad. Find a new genre of music to listen to. Go outside and walk. Meet new people. Enjoy the outside environment. Maybe go to an arcade, a bookstore, a local shop. Read a book. Write a book. Even just a short story. I don't want to preach at you guys, though. I just want us all to be able to enjoy the things we're attached to, without undue frustrations, without resentments, without anger, burnout, and suffering.
So, the Rhino Prime in the room, the video name, the channel name, how hard could it be? How hard was it to make this video? Let's discuss. Scripting took nearly the whole week on this one. I've actually been toying this idea in my head since shortly after the channel creation. With Nightwave Season 1 over, I wanted to put something out on this subject before Season 2 dropped. Thankfully, DE has staggered that release a little bit, buying me some extra time. I went through an initial write-up of this, and then did a whole bunch of edits around 4 to 6 a.m. Friday morning before I caught some shut-eye. Oh, also tags. I wrote out a whole bunch of tags this time around. Hopefully, it'll affect the algorithm and shit. There's a bit of a hassle with the sound this time around. I wanted some specific audio clips, one being the wrist rockets. I tried to get it from the game, but that's basically impossible. I tried to find a soundboard of sorts, but to no avail. I searched Google and found some forum threads about the sound files in Battlefront 2 Classic, even downloaded some stuff from their sources, and still couldn't find it. Finally, I just searched for the exact audio clip and I found it. I feel like a buffoon. Then there comes the 26 million registered losers. I split and cut the audio around, reduced the volume on one bit to manipulate Space Mom into saying losers properly. It's a little weird sounding, but worth it for the joke. On top of that, for the recording, I tried to go with a bit of an old-fashioned PSA kind of voice. Maybe a bit over top, but it made recording a little bit more fun. And one thing I will say, audio editing requires a lot of cutting out breaths. With trying to cover up my video clips, I had to learn how to move the still images over certain parts of the video instead of just keeping one plastered right in the middle like I did in Rage 2. Odd little process of having to shift and expand the frame over the actual picture while the picture itself stays static in the middle of the effects screen. Other than that, getting footage was moderately easy, though I did ask a few people for help, namely a certain helicopter friend of mine for the MapleStory footage, you know who you are, and my girlfriend provided the Warframe and Monster Hunter stuff. As for the thumbnail, I figured I'd make it as over the top as I possibly could, just for the laughs. Join me next time for the Jovian Concord. Something tells me that a certain lettuce mix has something fun in store for us. Outro, take us away.
Remember to like, subscribe, uncrack a relic, earn an epic pet, farm a conference call, take a break, use radiation on the wolf of Saturn 6.
Watch those wrist rockets!
And leave a comment down below about your own burnout experiences.